This morning on The Dish, the best of the Midwest from cookbook author and TV personality Shauna Sever. Raised in Illinois, Sever always remembered the cookies, pies, and other treats she enjoyed as a kid. What do you think of those pictures?
Who doesn't?
Right? For a time, she worked as a broadcast journalist covering the entertainment industry, but eventually started a blog that focused on baking.
Is that where I know you from? That led to her current work as a food expert for broadcasts such as NPR, Splendid Table, and publications such as Food and Wine. Just this week, she released her fourth cookbook, Midwest Made, Big Bold Baking from the Heartland.
Yes.
Yeah.
Shauna Sever.
We welcome you to The Dish.
Good morning. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
What you got on the table here?
Wow. Well, let's start with our fruit salad, actually. This is what I like to call my sweet and spicy fall fruit salad. So we've got some great fall and winter fruits in here. And it has a dressing on it, which a lot of fruit salads don't. Mm. So it's a spice-infused dressing on that salad. We have, let's go over to this end over here, to the cucumber salad. This is a Midwestern classic. So when you have a garden, lots of cucumbers, this is what you're gonna make with a Greek yogurt dressing, pickled red onion. We have a quick bread here, which is in the savory chapter of the book. We do have some savory baked goods. Lots of Wisconsin sharp cheddar and a nice beery sort of background there. The brisket is what I like to call a German braised brisket. So rather than any kind of barbecue sauce with vinegar, we're gonna use sauerkraut for that tang and tomato and a little bit of applesauce for sweetness. This is a roasted pear and pumpkin soup, perfect for fall. And then this is a poke cake. It is sort of a modern twist from scratch version of that kitschy retro classic.
The Midwest had such an impact on you. And as somebody who's from here, the food really is different. Why did you feel the need, though, to create the book that you have now after having such a varied background?
Well, to be honest, the great Toni Morrison said, I'm gonna ruin this quote, but if you can't find the book you want to read, you have to write it, right?
That's great.
So when I moved back to the Midwest after living in California for 13 years, I wanted this sort of heirloom recipe collection that could tell the story of all of these foods that I grew up with and other people grew up with. There really wasn't a book quite like it. And I think a big part of this book is the immigrant influences that are so deeply embedded in the region that we don't even know that they're there. And so that was the fun part for me, is pulling out the roots of all of these things that I really took for granted for a long time.
How do you go from broadcast journalism?
Do you want to make
Midwest
the switch?
Baking.
I was
going
to say,
no.
No, truthfully, I worked a lot in entertainment news. And after a while, it felt a little thin, you know? And I got into food at sort of the very beginning of food blogs as a way to sort of remember where I came from. And I was in L.A. at the time. But it really helped connect me to home. And then that sort of grew. So I started writing recipes professionally and then started writing books. And
well, this can be very short as thick.
Yes.
And delicious.
And we miss this piece.
Oh, the cocktail.
Yeah.
Yes. Anyone watching in Nebraska right now knows what this is.
Yes,
this
they
is red
do.
Beer.
Yeah.
This is red beer. So it's sort of like a Mexican michelada, but it's just tomato juice and a good American lager. And if you're going to tailgate, that's right. If you're going to drink in the morning, this is what I might
add a little tomato juice
to work on the hangover you had the night.
That's what people Midwestern Bloody Mary, basically.
You know, growing up, did you know, obviously, food came in later, but I guess what was food to you when you were a kid? For so many of us, it was comfort in the Midwest.
It was everything. I grew up in a really big family in the suburbs of Chicago. My grandfather did a ton of cooking, Greek and Italian, and we always had lots of pasta, lots of breads and delicious things. So food for me was... It was home, it was connection, and it was family.
That's what you've created here, certainly.
You.
Let's have you sign the dish.
Yes, of course.
And if you could have this meal with anyone, past or present, who would it be?
It would have to be my grandparents. I mean, making this book, I felt like they were with me the entire time, and I wish that they were here to see it and know that I brought my kids back to the Midwest. My grandma would love that to know. She passed about a year before we moved back. Aww. And I felt her with me the entire time making this book.
Wonderful. So congratulations on the book.
Thank you so much.
Chef Shauna Sever, if you want more on her or the dish, you can head to our website at cbsthismorning.com.